slash best good.
Huh?
I tried to do a lever.
Yeah. There. Yeah.
Oh, you want that?
Fans want to know, what are you doing today?
Right now, I am just opening up the lower back. So I'm going to train back, but I'm not going to go into my back workout yet. And the reason why is I've been on set the last 6 days. The last few days have been a lot of fighting and stuff. So, 12-hour days, standing, fighting. Lower back is sore. Stiff, not sore. Sorry, bad term.
So wouldn't you take the day off and let your back recover?
Take the day off. That's a great approach. Yeah, said nobody ever. So the best thing for me would be movement, just like pinpointed into the places that are stiff, sore, focus, push blood into it, and that's what I'm doing today. To start. This is not a workout that I'm doing right now. This is my warm-up for today's back workout, is loosening up the lower back so I can train back. I don't think anybody's ever talked in depth about that aspect of it, but sometimes that's gonna happen, especially if you're one of these guys like me that's, I haven't been a full-time bodybuilder since ever was. So I'm doing movies, I'm traveling, doing appearances, on planes, traveling, back on set, working out throughout everything. So there's days I'm banged up and I need to go in and open up the body before I even start the workout. So all the hyperextensions, all the ab work here, all the initial pull-ups I'm doing a tri-set, is strictly to get the body opened up so I can start warming up properly. So this isn't even technically a warm-up for my back yet.
Yo, tell me, what's Mo running right now? What y'all think? Y'all think she's gassed up or what? Yo, Powerhouse is the shit. Can you guys hear us talk? I know the music's loud. Anavar?
Yeah.
That's it?
Man, just Anavar?
Damn. They're trying to say you don't look that way anymore.
Yeah,
you're
right?
You're only running Anavar? You guys see that back extension form? A little different than you might be used to.
I don't really like the hyper and goals. I don't like
the straight one?
I don't like these anymore.
The angled.
Yeah, that just doesn't. It's like when we squat,
we're squatting into such a deep position, but we're also moving the knees out, you know, maybe feet are up. So there's a little bit more to it that connects more of the body.
Yeah.
So I like the hip. Is that what they call it?
The GHD machine.
Yeah, it's like a hip.
Something like that.
I like the whole connection through it. Firing all the way up through the glutes and the lower back. See, not even realizing it, that's probably why I love deadlift so much, because it's not just the back, but it's firing up the hips as well.
Right.
And when the hips feel good, I don't know if you guys can understand that, but you ever wake up in the morning, your lower back is stiff, you try to walk and you can't flex your abs that well, maybe, but then when it's loosened up, you can flex. It might be an aha moment later on in life, but for me, today I woke up and I was like, whoa, I'm stiff. You ever feel that way? Wake up and your back's stiff?
Yeah.
And it feels like it throws everything off?
Yeah.
If that back is out, it throws everything off.
If your back's fucked, you're fucked. Everything.
Such an important thing. The lower back is what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And the hamstring glute. It's so important to get through life with that being strong.
Yeah. I like the two extremes that you're doing. You're doing an extreme rounding forward on the extension, and then over here on the abs, you're doing more than an extreme flexion backwards.
Feels great. Yeah.
No, that's not dust. That's like some coating. It's like rock. I don't know what the fuck that is. I don't do construction. Some shit like that.
Okay. All right. Cool. Who's like, their people?
You guys like titties?
Who's their people? Is what's his name still part of it?
I got a new name.
No, I meant the person that was the face of the gym before. Oh, is he gone? I haven't seen anything. So when you talk to him, you set up a lunch with that person. Get in there and go.
See, that's not.
I still got the kids today.
Yeah, it's good for the low back, dude. Yeah, it's not. He's not rounding it. He's just got some fucking meat.
think I'd make 40, but I'm only 65. We're going out with the boots on. I know that. We're going out fight.
What's that?
I'm like, a little dirty here. How's that? A little better. Cleaned up that. Ooh, look at this.
What's up, Mike? How you doing? Good. No, it's yours. I saved it for you.
Okay.
This is how you look at it. Hold it. Get in there, kid. How's everything going?
Froggy the Frog. Yeah, it's right there.
No, it's in your pocket.
It's right there.
Yeah.
Look at that, guys. Dang. Look at that shimmer.
So, don't count on YouTube on this. It ain't gonna happen. Use the phone. This
way. I never do that.
Okay.
We want pull down, T-bar, row, pull-ups. Start with pull-ups.
Yeah.
I like.
Right here? I think so.
Right? Oh, yeah, no, that's work.
Thank you.
You guys doing these? First of all, are you guys doing pull-ups? And then second of all, when you are, you guys throwing in the belt? Oh, a little something on your lip?
A little something,
Gotcha.
I got a moment. Really, Amir?
Order that. Order a couple of those today.
Those kind of beer?
Yeah. Those are gold.
Inside grip. Eh? With the red handle? You're good. Can't just do two. Can't just do two sets. WWBD.
This is the one I put on this one.
New video. It's going up right now.
Jump. Jump in front of me.
Yep. Russia is in the building. You guys all from Russia? Yes, yes. Как дела? Shout outs to Russia.
Russia. Спасибо. До свидания.
Пизда. Chat, what does пизда mean? Good, good. Yes.
You're right onto the word.
Oh, I know what that means. It's the old poo nanny. Thank you. So, Mike, do you even break a sweat? You make it look so easy. Goal's not to break a sweat.
If it happens, it happens.
That might be a, that's a good little point.
Yeah.
Because if it does happen, it happens. Get a little bouncy, boy. So the question was, Mike, do you even break a sweat? You make it look so easy.
Jeff made a great point, so that's not the purpose of it. Mike is trying to get a good workout in. If I break a sweat, great. Remember, my water intake is going to be different than your guys'. Especially at this stage, my body fat is probably different than a lot of you guys. So, really, in the off season, sure I'll break a sweat. Retain a lot, you know. Body fat's probably around 9-10%. But right now, I'm in low digits. If my purpose was to break a sweat, I probably wouldn't get a good workout in.
Right.
Or if it was to get a pump, again, I wouldn't get a good workout in. A pump and a sweat for me at this stage. So I'm trying to go as slow as I can, still move as heavy as weight as I possibly can to retain the muscle.
You keep saying this stage. It kind of makes me think, like, wait, there's a strategy to this? There's a plan? There's times when you should have higher calories, times when you should do no cardio, times when you should bump the intensity?
It's interesting. Why was that? You guys let me know. Why was that loss about... I think a lot of you probably, most of you youngsters probably go, hey, I just train all year.
Yeah.
Then you don't train. Because that's not training.
You know what I think was lost?
What?
Delayed gratification. Earning something.
I don't even know that then. It's like, it's not that they're not smart, they just don't know.
And
a training plan
right.
is always a 8 to 12 week plan, and there's a point of starting and stopping. That plan. There's rep ranges, there's calorie intake, there's understanding what you're trying to get during that 12 weeks. So if you're the guy that goes in and goes, I just train all year, I just train, falls out, sorry, I'm training. You're just breaking your body down. You're one of these weekend warrior guys who think that if you just train every day, you're going to get jacked. That's the most basic shit in the world. If you're driving to point A to point B, you at least follow the directions to get there.
Yeah.
You guys are just driving around. You're just cruising. You got no point of what you're doing.
In your case, point A to point B is starting in Los Angeles, going to New York, crossing the ocean, going to Europe, through Asia, and then coming back around.
I got my flight. I got the food set up for that flight. I understand the time. And I'm relaxed to go. This is the process of it.
Yeah.
There's points where I'm resting. It's all a metaphor, guys. It goes slow. It's a metaphor. It's like, those are in every aspect of your training. Sometimes the rest are longer. Sometimes the rest are shorter. Sometimes the weight is extremely heavy, or sometimes the weight's just heavy. The calories are extremely high. Sometimes you're going without carbs. It's all in a plan, though. If you guys are not doing a plan, mostly weightlifting to try to look a certain way. If you guys are exercising to exercise, congratulations. If you're exercising to train how you change how you look and actually enhance your lifestyle, there's a plan. Mm-hmm. There's not a person on the planet that can tell otherwise. Listen, there's not a person on the planet, basically, that's 60 years old doing what they did when they were 19, 17. So there's a reason I got to this point. And it wasn't because I was fucking throwing darts at a board with no talent, no skills, and no understanding of it. There's a point to this thing. There's always a rhyme and a reason.
Guys, you're looking at a snapshot of a moment in time when you watch posts, videos, photos. Understand and rewatch this video, because he just dropped the key. And this, in 4 minutes, he just laid out the blueprint to success. Scotland. Saying delayed gratification. They see a post, they see a guy sweating, and unfortunately the guy sweating is going to tell you that's the fucking key to success. He's going to tell you that throwing a fucking ball at the wall, catching it, air squatting 50 times back to back with 100 air squats is going to be the fucking key to success, while he's dripping sweat, standing in his puddle weighing 143 pounds,
fat,
a fucking skinny fat.
Go to the gym today. Look around. Try to find some people that are in good shape. Watch what they're doing. How long they rest in between sets. The weights are important. And then try to find those people that are just going ballistic.
Yeah.
Doing 3-4 exercises in a row. You got a little corner in the gym just going crazy, dripping sweat, making noise, screaming and yelling.
The one that's relaxed and calm and quiet is in good shape. And the guy over there screaming and
yelling in a fitness gym is out of shape. I think you might be right. Pull it. Go underneath and pull straight to the face. You should be able to move a lot of weight on the floor.
Oh yeah, yeah, for the set. Yeah. Brazil. What month? Guys, come on. Santa, Brazil, bro.
Hey guys,
with the statue. Rio de Janeiro. That's the one. get the others.
Thank you.
I don't mind those noises in the back.
Thank you.
Any questions, guys? I've been doing cardio for quite some time now. Any gym tips? What do you think about Mike Mentz's method of training? Yeah, he will be in there with Rampage. Not even, bro. Yeah. 1 hour rest for sure. Watch it, watch it.
This was a secondary. You get the shot.
Mike, what is best in life?
The real ones will get that.
That feels ridiculous.
Shot right here. Let's do that big lat stretch. One, you get a really big fucking lat stretch.
Yeah.
Two, you get insane. You guys ever hit a lat spread, a rear lat spread? You know how you kind of cock it before you spread it? You pull everything back, you grab the lower back, the hips, and then you wrap. The pull and the contraction. You're all the way. Yeah, so there's a lot of things going on in the exercise. And especially, just like we talked about earlier, guys, think about what stage Mike is at. Guys. They keep asking, Mike, when's you in Rampage? When are you stepping in? Mike, what's your favorite body part on your whole body? Yeah, buddy. I don't know, we haven't seen that guy in a while. Thank you. Really good light right here.
Alright. Please read my comment. I'm homeless. Damn, bro.
Sorry,
you do it.
So make sure to post.
That is it, guys. Hope you liked this shit today. I'll be doing more lives like this on YouTube, on Mike's page, vertical, random ass, just hitting it. Peace.